Welcome to GrayYeon Map. We are asked to solve for this problem. We are given two lines that intersect at point A, and in these two lines are inscribed several isosceles triangles. We are given the angle alpha, which is 10 degrees, and we are to find the angle beta. Okay, so but before that, may I request you to please like this video. Okay, so for this problem, we are going to use two theorems. The exterior angle theorem, which states that the exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of the two opposite interior angles. In this example, the opposite interior angles are A and B, and their sum is equal to D, which is the exterior angle. And for the next theorem, we are going to use the vertical angle theorem. So for the vertical angle theorem, this theorem states that if two angles are vertical, then they are congruent. In this case, angle 4 and 2 are vertical angles, then they are congruent. And angle 1 and angle 3 are vertical angles, so they are congruent. They have the same measurement. These are vertical angles. Vertical angles are pairs of opposite angles made by intersecting lines. Okay, so first thing that we have to do is we need to focus on triangle AEB. And we see that angle BAE, which is given as a measurement of alpha. And again, since this is an isosceles triangle, then we can say that the angles opposite the two congruent sides are equal, and therefore ABE should be alpha also. And next thing is we need to use the exterior angle theorem. Okay, so for the exterior angle theorem, this we need to use the segment EF as the extension of segment AE, and this angle BEF should be 2 times alpha, because you need to add these two alphas here. Okay, and next is we need to focus on triangle BEF. Triangle BEF again is an isosceles triangle, and in an isosceles triangle, once again, the angles opposite the two congruent sides have the same angle, and therefore angle BFE is also 2 alpha. Okay, so next thing that we have to do is we need to extend this segment BE. Okay, so if we extend that segment BE, then we can get an exterior angle here. And this exterior angle is actually 2 alpha plus 2 alpha, or 4 alpha. And next is we focus on these two angles, this angle here and this angle ABE. And ABE is actually alpha. And this angle should be also alpha, because they are vertical angles, as we have discussed earlier. And since this is alpha, then this angle here should be 4 alpha minus alpha, which is 3 alpha. Okay, and next, if we focus on triangle BCF. And in triangle BCF, again, is an isosceles triangle. And this isosceles triangle, I mean, in any isosceles triangle, the angles opposite the two congruent sides should have the same measurement, then therefore angle BCF should have a measurement of 3 alpha. Okay, so next thing that we have to do is we need to extend the segment BF. Okay, if we extend the segment BF, we again can get the exterior angle here. And the exterior angle is simply 3 alpha plus 3 alpha, and that is 6 alpha. Okay. And if we got 6 alpha here, then this vertical angle BFE is a vertical angle with this angle F. And if that is 2 alpha for BFE, then we have here, it measures 2 alpha. Okay, so this angle measures 6 minus 2 is equal to 4 alpha. And again, the triangle FCG being an isosceles triangle, then the angles opposite the congruent sides are equal. So this is 4 alpha. Okay, so next thing that we have to do is we need to extend the segment FC. So if we again extend segment FC, then we get an exterior angle here. And the exterior angle here measures actually 8 alpha. Because it is 4 alpha plus 4 alpha. Then if you subtract this 3 alpha here, this is 3 alpha because of vertical angle theorem. It is vertical with angle BCF. So 8 alpha minus 3 alpha. So this interior angle here should be 5 alpha. And again, next triangle, if you focus on CDG, which is an isosceles triangle, then this 5 alpha is congruent with this angle CDG, 5 alpha, because it is also opposite the congruent sides. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is we need to extend the segment CG. So if we extend that segment, then we can see an exterior angle here. And this measures 5 alpha plus 5 alpha, and that is 10 alpha. And notice also that angle CGF is a vertical angle with this angle here. Then this should measure 4 alpha. And if that is 4 alpha, then this angle DGH should measure 10 alpha minus 4 alpha, and that is 6 alpha. And since triangle DGH is an isosceles triangle, then this should measure 6 alpha also, because it is opposite to one of the two congruent sides. Okay, so for the next step is we need to extend the segment DG. And if we extend the segment DG, then we form an exterior angle here. And this exterior angle should measure the sum of 6 alpha and 6 alpha, and that measures 12 alpha. And next thing that we have to notice is we notice that this angle here is a vertical angle with angle CDG, and that is 5 alpha. And for the final step is we need to subtract the vertical angle from this exterior angle, and that gives us 12 alpha minus 5 alpha. And that gives us 7 alpha. And we notice that the 7 alpha is the angle we are looking for. And beta is equal to 7 alpha. And beta is equal to 7 times 10 degrees. And beta is equal to 70 degrees. And that is our answer. So thank you for watching until the end of the video. Please like the video if you like our solution, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be updated for more math videos like this. Thank you. Bye.